see. Maybe. Hot.
Let's get right into it. I started off with my favorite primer, the Poreffessional. I love this stuff. It gives my makeup a more matte, velvety feel, and it actually sticks to my face. I just swear by this Bible, not to get Kim Kardashian on you. Primer. I swear by it. First things first, eyebrows, the most important, believe it or not, part of your face. I feel like it is. It just gives it that dramatic, bold, intense feel. I use the Anastasia gel pomade and also the wand itself just to give my hair. This is what actually how I start off doing my eyebrows, just putting my hair towards my face, not outwards, so like not away from my face. And then I use my little Stubby brush and just finesse the eyebrows. Like, this is literally how I do my eyebrows, like every day if I'm going out on an everyday basis. And then I'm gonna probably most likely go in with a darker shade. I ended up using, you guys know, my favorite gold palette, James Charles Morphe palette. I used the dark brown to make my eyebrows a little bit more of a thicker feel. And Bellatrix, her hair is black, but I feel like it's a little bit dark brown in some parts. So I just also went in with the Stooley again and shaded it out with the mascara part. Then I went in with my favorite NARS creamy concealer. This is in the shade Custard. This is the lightest shade I have. I was going to use my macadamia shade, but this is like the travel size. It ran out. I actually used this on a trip and it's basically done. I have like a million more, but macadamia and custard are probably my favorite colors. I need to restock on the custard one because custard is lighter and it's winter. Well, basically I feel like it's freezing my room right now. So I need to restock on the Custard NARS Creamy Concealer. Then I use a beauty blender. I just highlight all my face. I use it on my forehead. I clean up my eyebrows with an angled brush. Blend, 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 blend. This is going to be a video all about blending, believe it or not.
This is like what I'm really petrified for, to use the Fenty Beauty Underdog color, because I wanted it to look be a little bit creamy for her dark circles. And this is like the closest color. I was gonna use a shadow, but I wanted it to look a little bit more deeper. And I feel like this color would really pop. So I'm really scared. So I'm just gonna put like a little bit and then just like build around like my eyes. So yeah. And I'm also gonna use this as a lip color. So let's just do that. Let's just do two dots right now. And then see. So, don't worry, we're gonna like build this out. Yeah, thank God I only did two dots because that would be like terrifying for me. Okay. Okay, this is where we blend out. Okay, it doesn't look so bad now. So yeah, Bellatrix is Lestrange. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I'm terrified of her. So we're gonna see how this look ends up coming out because I'm in high fun. It's a kind of like a bruised look. That's what it looks like a bruised look from being a Death Eater. It's hard to be a Death Eater, honestly. I'm gonna I'm gonna clean it up with, some of concealer because just these shirt lines, I don't really need that much, but I'm looking at myself right now and I look freaking scary. I'm gonna use some white powders from NYX. HD finishing powder to not make it look so freaking scary. I like how the color looks nice on my eyes though, so that's nice. This would not look terrifying, but I'm terrified right now.
I recorded like half voiceover and the rest is just me talking because my brother is literally watching the baseball game right there, of course, right next to. No one respects me in this house. I blended out a little bit more with a blending brush. I feel like I didn't look tired enough. I am a death eater. I need to embrace this tiredness of doing dark magic night and day. Literally, it's not taking over enough, so I need to be more tired. After I blended off enough of the under eyes, I went in to clean up the mess with my creamy concealer from NARS again. And I got a new beauty blender, Block. I don't know how I feel about it. I feel like it's going to blend in with everything because most of my makeup product carries in black. So I feel like it's a camouflage. Like I said, this video is just me blending out my tired eyes the most. I want to look the most naturally tired as possible. Literally, I went in again with the color with my blending brush, blend under your eyes, on your eyelids, just to make it match and drag out to make it look like more natural tired feel look. There you go, she looks tired. Then I went in with my Fenty Beauty baking powder. This is in the shade Banana. This actually kind of smells, I'm not gonna lie to you guys, like a little bit like banana. I don't mind it. I highlighted my cheeks and my forehead because right after I'm going to contour my face to look so disgustingly sick. Like, it's just gonna be sick, 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 sick. The color I'm using to contour my face is the Fenty Beauty Bronzer in Bajan Girl. I hope I said it right. Bajan Girl. Bajan Girl. Bajan Girl. And then I used the actual same color I used under my eyes from the palette to make it look more of a dark feel, not as bronzy. I'm not trying to be that glammed up. I'm trying to look sick as F. Now I'm going to clean it up the excess contour and with some concealer just to angle my face a little bit sharper and nastier because, you know, out here doing dark magic, you can't be looking cute. You got to look nasty, sharp and nasty. I feel like the way I say nasty reminds me of somebody I know. Who says it like that? Anyways, blend the contour, and then eventually I go up to my baking face and blend out the rest with the black beauty blender as well. Blend. I told you I'm just blending this entire video.
It's like really hard, guys, being a deaf eater. Like, this is what I do to wake up every day, you know. And to blend it out more. But like, you know what I mean? It's just so hard. I literally look like I'm dying. Now that I have my face good, I have like makeup like all, my face is good. I'm gonna do just top liner, smudge out the bottom and do mascara. And then I'm gonna do the lip and then I'm done. The lip takes the longest for me, but I think we'll make it work. I'm gonna try to do like a smudge effect. I'm not gonna, from the end, what is this called? I forgot. The Underdog from Fenty Beauty liquid liner, lip liner, lip. I can't speak right now. So yeah, I feel like the face is good. I look tired enough. You can go as tired as you want, but I feel like it's good. You guys know this part is like the hardest for me, like the hardest part, literally. I'm using Kat Von D tattoo liner. This is what I'm doing. I'm trying to make it as sharp as possible that I can kill somebody with literally just my looks. Okay. Ooh, that's sharp. Now that everything's like cleaned up, I'm gonna do the bottom. This one's gonna be a little bit annoying because I'm gonna use black and I'm always terrified. Oh my god. Of using black like on my, all right, I'm gonna take the black with a smudge brush. And just smudge out my bottom line, waterline. You can use, guys, Don't be afraid to use water liner. But I feel like the smudger makes it look sharper. Not sharper, but like scarier. Like this is what, you know what's crazy? I'm gonna do all these costumes, right? But I'm probably not gonna beat any of them because I don't think I'm banging nobody I know is having a Halloween party. Okay, that's good. Yeah, that's good. This is like my favorite brush. It literally smudges everything. It's literally meant for smudge. Oh, it doesn't say it because I went away. But it's my favorite. Okay, so we're done with line. I'm gonna try to probably do my hair. I already have crazy hair. Curly. That was Lisa's curly hair. It's more like finer, but I'm not gonna do it defined. What I'm gonna end up doing is, this is how, I can't take myself seriously with my makeup like this. I'm gonna brush out the curls actually. You know, Bellatrix is a witch. So I'm just gonna wet those parts out because that's what I got makeup on. I'm not gonna do my lip just now because I know when I'm doing my makeup. Oh, I forgot one more thing. The Morphe. Just so the makeup can really set and go into my face. The continuous spray. If you don't have, I could do the big thing that she has. I can do that, right? But I feel like it's not as scary. So maybe I can like leave the top like this. And then the rest I could just brush out. Like that's what I'm gonna do the rest. I'm gonna just probably brush out. Okay. Oh, I have to wash my hair after this. This sucks. Okay. I'm gonna use the Tangle Tamer Denman brush to brush these curls out. I don't condone brushing your hair, your curls, when they're dry because it literally does so much damage, but this is just for this one time. So her hair is definitely, I don't think Bellatrix has, I'm gonna call her Trix, you know, it's just Bellatrix is a tongue. Has like a hairstylist, believe it or not. I think her hair, she just throws it up in whatever she has. I'm taking a huge banana clip, right? Oh, hold on. And just leaving it like that. That looks really cute, guys. She does have a long strand right here that is gray. Why am I terrified to use this one? Because Colorista, believe it or not, when I was blonde, I used this brand on my hair. Pink for Harley Quinn. This was like a Harley Quinn video. And it did not come off my hair. So I'm very scared. I'm probably gonna put a little bit more on this side, guys. Hold on. Just like right here, maybe. I just want it to look big. It's already big, but like super big. Okay. Oh, that looks really pretty. Like I'm obsessed with how I look right now. I'm obsessed on how I look right now, guys. I would leave my house like this. I would. But my Dominican mom would kill me. And just leave the rest like in a top crown. Yeah, that's cute. Oh, wow. I'm obsessed. I'm so scared right now. I'm just gonna take a piece like this and like, hold on. I'll just like brush it out or something. I know. Not a lot, not a lot. Cause like, I feel like. Oh! Got it on my shirt. I'm terrified to do this. I'm gonna brush it out again to make it look a little bit more natural, like my hair is actually gray right here. Okay, that's good. Okay, all right. Okay.
Then I used Beat from MAC lip liner to line my lips. The color I ended up using was the same Underdog I used under my eyes, the same tone. The thing is that this liquid liner lipstick is super, super liquidy. So I had to like keep reapplying. I got some like everywhere, it kept sliding out, I guess, because my lips were too moisturized in the beginning. And I felt like I needed to put more moisturizer. I don't know. But eventually I got it. I got it around. I just had to keep reapplying because it kept smudging out everywhere. It was a mess. I forgot how liquidy. I don't have this problem with the red lip from Rihanna Fenty Beauty, the unscented one. This is the Underdog one, but I don't feel like I have the same problem with this one. So it was a little bit of annoying to keep reapplying. So yeah.
I feel like I look like a bad witch. Bad witch. I'm obsessed on how it came out. Like, I couldn't ask for a better, I was gonna make it more narrow like that, but the bigger, the scarier. Oh yeah. Obvio, I am Bellatrix Lestrange. How do you say that in Spanish? Bellatrix Lestrange. And this was definitely one of my favorite looks. It was super easy, believe it or not, because my hair was already curly. Bellatrix has her hair kind of sometimes a mess. I mean, you know, she's out here doing dark magic, so she can't be like, she doesn't have time to be glamming it up. That is it for this week's video. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I dare you to be curly, and I dare you to be yourself, your crazy bad witchy self. All right.